Hello, lovely people.
I would like to give you some tip. Here, Michal Kali Griks from Tantra Movement, from the course Loving Better. Today I will speak about oneness, about connection as one of the aspects of love. So in Tantra Movement, we, as a main intention, set up ourselves to learn how to love better and doing it. Connection, it's one of the expression of love. Yes, where there is love, there is connection, and as more connection, then more love. They are co-independent things to each other. So yes, as more we are connected, then we can love others better. If we are connected with them better, we can feel them better, and so on and so on. And that's what also bring us into oneness, that we actually can feel them and to realize that we may become one. Tantra is guiding us into the oneness. Oneness, it's very important in Tantra to realize that you are one with nature, you are one with your partner, your beloved ones, you are one with your family, and you are one even with all cosmos, all universe. We are part of it, and as fingers are part of the hand, we are part of the universe, and as a part of divine life, divine miracle, as a part of everything, and so on. Yeah, some people call it God. Separation is one of the main illusions in life, and Tantra is through the experiences, through guiding you to the sublimation, bringing the energy up and experiencing the cosmic orgasm, when you feel a state of nirvana, samadhi, where there is no more separation between you and your partner, within your cells and organs, you can feel your whole body. There is no separation with the nature. You feel like Mother Earth is breathing with you, and you are part of it. Yes, there is no separation at all. You feel as a part of this divine being, what is called life, what is called love. Some people call it God, however you like to call it. We are all one, and that's we have to realize. And when we realize this, especially when you experience with Tantra, you will not have to believe in it anymore. But because you will know that you experience it, what you experience, it exists. So when you know it, when you experience this oneness, then you would always guide your life that you would like to see people happy. Because their happiness, it's your happiness. And you will become more empathic and more connected with the nature animals. So you will may feel even sad when the tree is cut for no reason. Yes, most of the people who are become connecting with themselves and connecting with nature, they don't want to harm animals. It's very popular that in the spiritual circles, not only tantric, people become vegan because they feel empathic more and more with your spiritual growth towards oneness, towards connection. Your empathy level also grow, and you will become uncomfortable. Your body even may become uncomfortable to eat something what had suffering, had fear in themselves. So I wish that we all make steps toward oneness, and we realize that most of the beautiful thing what we like in our life, like connection, connecting with people, being social, being appreciated, gratitude, thankfulness, social living, friendship,
neighborhood, the group what we like to belong,
family, unity,
love.
That's all guide us, our heart, into the oneness, into connection, into not being separated. And that's what we enjoy. And actually isolation, it's the something what we are suffering from. Look at the one of the worst punishment what we do to other human beings. It's to isolate them, to separate them. Let's don't go for the separating ourselves into the whatever ways. Let's focus on the connecting.
I would like to give you one beautiful advice for relationships, but also for our living, because in the end we relate it with everyone.
Choose always to connect, not to separate.
Always when you meet the person, especially your beloved one, in your relationship.
Also with ourselves.
Focus always on the things what are connecting you. Try to look not too much and pay too much attention on the things what are separating you.
We are conditioned by many things through our life to separate from each other. We are conditioned to take care only for ourselves. We are conditioned to live in the houses, do things just for ourselves. If you focus in your relationship on the things what connect you, what not, what the things annoy you, but with the things what you really like about the person, what you appreciate about the person, not the things what make you push away. So I believe that, and I know from experience, that when you focus on these good things as in relationship, as in life, then the bad things will have less and less place to be, to exist. They would be pushed away by the instant growth of all beautiful, positive, good things. So yes, always focus on the good things, and yes, sometimes you have to go through the bad things, that the things can be healed, some past trauma.
It's up to you which wolf you will choose to feed. I wish you go for, stay connected, create more connections in your life, less separation. Aho, thank you for your attention.